Good afternoon, dear colleagues and guests. We are ready to start our meeting. Please, dear board members, switch on your video cameras. Thank you very much. Good afternoon, distinguished colleagues and guests. Today, it is the 9th of June, 2021, 3 p.m. Moscow time, and allow me to consider open the meeting of the Dissertation Council for the Defense. Allow me to consider open the meeting of the Dissertation Council for the Defense of Maria Edinova's dissertation for the degree of the candidate of political sciences in the scientific specialization 230005, political regional studies, ethnopolitics, on the topic the peculiarities of the regional and city migration policy, the issue of migrants' integration into the host society. According to the order of Alexander Gnyotov, St. Petersburg University Scientific Secretary, dated from March 31, 2021, number 25-21/1, me, Olga Popova, Doctor of Political Sciences, professor with assigned duties of the head of the Department of Political Institutions and Applied Political Research, St. Petersburg University, was appointed the chairperson of this dissertation council. And by the same order, the members of the Dissertation Council were approved. Let me introduce them. Natalia Vasilieva, Doctor of Philosophical Sciences, Professor of the Department of World Politics, St. Petersburg University. In the remote interactive mode, we have got Ivan Radikov, Doctor of Political Sciences, Acting Head of the Department of Russian Politics, St. Petersburg University. Ivan, can you see and hear us? I can see you, but the sound is very poor. I will try to speak louder. Now I can see, hear you perfectly. If Ivan reacts, it means that the answer is positive. Yuri Shabaev, Doctor of Historical Sciences, Head of Ethnography Sector, the Institute of Language, Literature and History of Komi, Scientific Center of Ural Department of the Russian Academy of Sciences. Yuri, can you see and hear us? Yes, I can. Thank you. The answer is positive. Our colleague from Armenia, Artur Atanisyan, Doctor of Political Sciences, Professor of the Faculty of Sociology, Yerevan State University, Armenia. Artur, can you see and hear us? Yes, I can see and hear you perfectly. Dear colleagues, I am here with you. Our applicant, Maria Edinova, is also here with us. Also here with us, there is a scientific supervisor, Valery Achkasov, Doctor of Political Sciences, Professor, Head of the Department of Ethnopolitology, St. Petersburg University. To improve the quality of communication, I ask you, dear colleagues, who are in the remote interactive mode, to turn off your microphones, but do not forget to turn them on when you are given the floor. And please don't switch off video. I also inform you that audio and video recording of our meeting is being conducted, as well as the live broadcast on the St. Petersburg University website. Simultaneous interpretation of speeches from Russian into English is being provided. At this time, an email address is posted on the live broadcast of the meeting of the Dissertation Council, where during the meeting all listeners can express their opinions and send questions to the applicant online concerning her dissertation and the current scientific discussion of her speech. Thus, such people can participate in scientific discussion. These questions will be forwarded to me by technical services, and I will voice them during the discussion. Questions must be related to the applicant's presentation and the content of your dissertation, and the name, position, and place of work of the author of the question must be indicated. questions that are not related to the scientific discussion, to the discussion of the dissertation, to the text and assessment of the dissertation itself, will not be voiced, as well as anonymous questions. In accordance with the procedure for awarding the academic degree of the candidate of sciences, academic degree of Doctor of Sciences at St. Petersburg University, approved by local regulations of St. Petersburg University, hereinafter the procedure, a meeting of the Dissertation Council is considered eligible if at least two-thirds of the approved membership of the Council takes part in its work, but not less than four people. Our Dissertation Council consists of five people. Five members are present, including three members in the remote interactive mode. All members of the Dissertation Council and the applicants are provided with audiovisual contact, thus there is a quorum. The procedure of today's meeting of the Dissertation Council with a total duration of approximately 2 hours is the following. Number one, a brief report of the chairman on the documents submitted by the applicant for a scientific degree and their compliance with the established requirements. Answers to possible questions, about 5 minutes. Number two, a short presentation by the applicant for a scientific degree reflecting the main points of your research, approximately 15 minutes. Number three, questions to the applicant strictly according to her report, no more than 2 minutes per question. Number four, answers of the applicant, no more than 15 minutes for all questions. Number five, speeches of all members of the Dissertation Council, in turn, with their assessment of the dissertation research, with the summary of their positions, with questions and suggestions for the dissertation, about 10 minutes per speaker. Number six, the speech of the chairperson with the review, about 10 minutes. Answers of the applicant for a scientific degree to questions and comments of the members of the Dissertation Council, no more than 20 minutes. Number eight, open discussion. Speeches at the request of those present at the defense of the dissertation, with a summary of their positions and or with specific questions and proposals for the dissertation strictly on the topic of their research. No more than 2 minutes for everyone, for each volunteer. At the same time, all interested people are requested to register in the registration form and completely introduce themselves before your performance. Then presentation by the chairman of questions addressed to the applicant, which came in order to discuss her speech and scientific discussion on the broadcast of the meeting of the Dissertation Council on the St. Petersburg University website. Written questions, which take more than 2 minutes, won't be voiced. Then answers of the applicant, no more than 2 minutes per question. Number 11, speech of the scientific supervisor of the applicant, no more than 3 minutes. 12, discussion of the results of the defense by the members of the Dissertation Council before the open vote, during which the sound of the broadcast is muted, about 5 minutes. 13, open roll call, counting of votes by the chairman of the Dissertation Council with the entry of the results into the minutes of the meeting. 14, making a decision on awarding or not awarding an academic degree. 15, concluding remarks of the applicant, no more than 2 minutes. Dear colleagues, are there any questions or objections to this regulation? If there are no objections, I will proceed to the implementation of the rules of the meeting. But before, please turn off the sound of mobile phones. Dear board members who are in the remote interactive mode, please don't switch off your mobile phones in order to connect with you in case of technical breakdowns. So I'm starting to conduct the meeting. Dissertation of Maria Edinova for the degree of the candidate of political sciences, specialization 230005, political regional studies, ethnopolitics. The topic, the peculiarities of regional and city integration policy, the issue of migrants' integration into the host society, was accepted for the defense by the order of Alexander Negnyotov, the academic secretary of St. Petersburg University, from the 11th of March, 2021. Number 1754/1, Maria Edinova wrote her dissertation research on the basis of St. Petersburg University. Her scientific supervisor is Doctor of Political Sciences, Professor head of the Department of Ethnopolitics, St. Petersburg University, Valeriy Achkasov. The number of publications of the applicant, in which the main scientific results of the dissertation are stated, according to the list presented, 7 publications. There are 3 articles in peer-reviewed scientific publications from the list approved by the Ministry of Education and Science of the Russian Federation. There is 1 publication in journals indexed in the scientometric databases, websites, and Scopus. The applicant for the degree submitted to the Scientific Secretary of St. Petersburg University complete package of documents for acceptance for consideration and defense of the thesis. All documents correspond to Clause 12, Section 3 of the procedure. All the documents submitted by the applicant on the information are received from the curator meet the requirements and are stored in the applicant's certification file. Their copies are held by an employee of the Department for Maintenance the activities of dissertation councils, who is now in the hall. Before giving the floor to the applicant, dear members of the dissertation council, do you have general questions to the applicant? And if there is a necessity to announce and consider the entire list of documents submitted by the applicant for the defense? No questions. If I'm not mistaken, Maria, the floor is yours. Good afternoon, dear chairperson and board members. Let me bring to your attention dissertation research on the topic Features of Regional and City Migration Policy, the Problem of Integrating Migrants at the Host Community. The importance of the policy of integrating migrants is evident today, based on the fact that the city authorities are the first government bodies that face inter-ethnic conflicts. The city is a key player in the policy of integrating migrants. This configuration confirms this and strengthens the existing trend towards multi-level governance in the process of making political decisions regarding the integration of migrants, which gained popularity after the 2008 financial crisis and the migration crisis that began in Europe in 2015. Unlike the largest cities in Europe, Russian cities have no experience in migrant integration policies. This is due to the fact that during the Soviet era, post-Soviet era, migrants easily adapted to the new environment due to the spread of the Russian language, the general education system, and the same qualification standards laid down by the Soviet system. Today, new generations of migrants obviously have great distinctive features in terms of language proficiency, functioning of the institution of the host community, qualification requirements, etc. Thus, in domestic practice, there is no experience of long-term implementation of the policy of integration of migrants, which necessitates the generalization and systemization of European experience. It should be emphasized that the crisis associated with pandemic has a significant impact on the transformation of migration flows, which have decreased. But nevertheless, the issue of finding conditions and mechanisms for effective integration into the host community do not lose their relevance. Research into the policy of integrating migrants has become widespread among both domestic and foreign scientists. Within the framework of the work, 8 conditional thematic areas in the study of migration processes have been identified, which are of key importance for the analysis of the policy of integration of migrants. The purpose of this study is to identify the features of regional and city migration policy and conceptualization of the indexation model of the degree of integration of migrants into the host community. On the example of cities and regions of Russia, St. Petersburg, Spain, Andalusia, Basque Country, Italy, the Netherlands, Great Britain, Germany, France. The tasks of the research: generalization and systematization of theoretical and methodological approaches of the study of regional and urban policy of integration of migrants, structuring and topologization of policy research dialogues in the production and use of knowledge. Comparative analysis of the policy of integration of migrants carried out by regional and city levels of government. Allocation and generalization of the main parameters of the indexation of the integration of migrants into the host community. Typology of institutions created to implement the policy of integration of migrants at the regional and city levels. Analysis of interaction of actors implementing the policy of integration of migrants at the local level and the identification of mechanisms for their coordination The main provisions for the defense are the following. The analysis carried out by the author complements this and systematizes the studies of the policy of integration of migrants implemented by the local level of governments, in addition to the sufficiently detailed cases of Great Britain, Germany, and France, and analysis of regions and cities of Spain, Italy, and the Netherlands that are underrepresented in domestic studies is carried out. The indexing system proposed in the study can be used for regional and city levels in the prevention of potential ethnic and confessional conflicts. The methodological basis of this study is the synthesis of comparative and systematic analysis and the methodology of neo-institutionalism. For this study, the main features of neo-institutionalism are of fundamental importance, consisting in the shift of the researcher's focus from formal structures to the analysis of institutional fields, the totality of social norms and values. So, in relation to the studied area, within the framework of neo-institutionalism, various models of integration policy are conceptualized as structures of opportunities that influence the behavior of migrants. The author relies on such approaches within the framework of new institutionalism as normative for analyzing the value and legal normative basis of the activities, modern institutions, historical institutionalism for research. Path of dependence conditioned by the adopted political decisions in the development of institutions in various cases. As a result of systematization of theoretical and methodological approaches, a definition of the policy for the integration of migrants was developed. Based on the definition presented on the slide, it is obvious that an integrated approach to the study of migration is needed, including the following parameters: countries of origin, purpose and type of migration, their reasons, and formal and informal interaction of authorities with each other and with communities. The general strategy of the policy of integration of migrants at the national level is in most cases conditioned by the historical migration policy. At the local level, strategies are transformed depending on the specific characteristics of migration flows, political and economic characteristics of the region or city. As a result, the following features of the policy of integration of migrants at the regional and city levels can be distinguished. Regional and city authorities are dependent on their center in terms of resources and powers to implement the policy of integration of migrants. At the local level, elements are called soft spheres of politics prevail by creating special sub-programs. The city government is focusing on the provision of social services, housing to migrants, and governance through communities. Bodies of regional and city authorities have the right to interact with countries of origin in terms of professional training of migrants. At the local level, channels of interaction and cooperation with business on the problems of migrants, access to the labor market, are being created. Regional and city authorities in some cases have the right to grant migrants the status of pre-citizenship. One of the widespread models of interaction in the production and use of knowledge in the field of migration policy and the policy of integration of migrants is political research dialogues. In Russia, a request for the model of mutual learning within the framework of policy research dialogues begins to form, which is reflected in the studied case of the communication platform of St. Petersburg International Labor Forum on the topic of migration policy. The most frequently implemented practices of policy research dialogues and bureaucratic and consultative models, which involves the use of expert knowledge to legitimize and justify the current policy of integration of migrants. Analyzing the institutional design created to implement the policy of integration of migrants at the regional city levels, the author identifies the centralist, local, multi-level, and separate types. In St. Petersburg, the centralist type with elements of multi-level norms prevails, and elements of the legal, economic, and instrumental types of integration of migrants are implemented to a great extent without taking into account the types of migration flows, which leads to certain costs in terms of activities. In the case of the autonomous community of Andalusia, from a normative point of view, the local type is presented and the principle of subsidiary is implemented. During the analysis of network structures and institutional relations, it was found that the policy of integration of migrants in the autonomous community contains elements of multi-level governance. Andalusia implements elements of social, economic, legal, instrumental, and cultural types of integration of migrants. For example, an integrated approach was chosen. Some associations of migrants, based on the analysis of the organizations of immigrant communities, it can be concluded that migrant associations are fragmented, have insufficient resources, depend on the phenomenon of ethnic entrepreneurship, and tend to expand the agenda from ethnocultural to social economic, which determines more influence on the policy of the integration of migrants at the local level by NGOs and non-profit organizations representing the rights of minorities, migrants or refugees without ethnic and cultural differentiation. The system of indexing migrants to the host community is carried out in three areas: the labor market, social welfare, and access to civil rights. In addition to quantitative indicators within these areas, it is necessary to measure qualitative indicators based on the assessment of representatives of the expert community, government bodies, civil society, and the opinions of migrants themselves. Thus, the analysis of qualitative indicators provides information on the effectiveness of measures taken to integrate migrants. Of course, the pandemic has significantly affected all spheres of society, and the policy of integrating migrants was no exception. The deployment of measures to support migrants' families during the first and second waves of the pandemic in the cases under the study may prompt the creation of new integration tools, allow establish communication channels with employers, migrants, and strengthening coordination with public organizations. I have finished. Dear board members, do you have any questions strictly according to the report? I would like to ask, as we know, in Western countries, there is a problem of ethnic economy. What can you say in this respect about St. Petersburg? Is there such a trend, and what our governmental authorities do for that? If I'm right, the question about specific economic sectors where this or that ethnos works. Due to pandemic, over 2020, a large number of citizens from Kyrgyzstan left St. Petersburg because they were employed in catering, hospitality business, and they suffered most of all during the first wave of pandemic when everything was closed. Are you satisfied with the answer? Dear colleagues, any other questions? Yuri Petrovich? Yes, please ask question. In the center of your attention, in your analysis, there is St. Petersburg and Andalusia. In my review, I have a question concerning migrants from Andalusia. In Andalusia, you marked, and what are the flows from Morocco between Arabs, for example? Thank you for your question. Unfortunately, according to official statistical data, there is no statistics which divide migrants to Arabs and Berbers, but Morocco is against ruling elites from previous scandals in Spain. Nowadays, the head of Front Polisario, Ibrahim Gari, is suffered from COVID, and it was the reason for scandal between Morocco and Spain, and Morocco reduced the number of the control on the border, and it led to a huge current of illegal migrants. they went to Melilla and Exota. It is due to influence of opposing non-profit organizations. Thank you, colleagues. Are there any other questions? Now let us turn to feedback. And I want to ask you a question. Is it convenient for you to answer after each speaker or after all speakers? After all speakers, it would be more convenient for me. Dear colleagues, please take it into account. There are no external reviews concerning the dissertation. You know that your reviews are placed on the website of St. Petersburg University. You may either read them out or focus only on problematic points. Dear colleagues, this research is actual. It concerns not only of our concerns not only our country but other countries' migration. It is the bright phenomenon of world politics. I would like to focus on such an important point of any dissertation as novelty, and it is proved by a set of provisions. They reflect authors' approach, systematizations of theoretical and practical experience accumulated while studying local level of decision-making process within the frames of migration policy. And in fact, for me, the comparison of Petersburg and Andalusia is an interesting fact. At first sight, they are distant locations, but here the author showed interesting scientific approach. What is important? Due to the fact that migration problem is very acute, in the dissertation we can see the opportunity which help understand practical significance of the dissertation, the opportunity to apply it of our authorities in order to improve multi-level policy concerning migration. I want to highlight that the dissertation is based on a large number of sources. The material is very diverse, and it is the advantage of the study. I'm not going to stop on the content of each chapter. My review is placed on the website of the university, and if you want, you may get acquainted with my review there. I want to say that due to the fact that any research has drawbacks or discussive questions, on the whole, the research is a completed independent scientific work which is accomplished at good theoretical and methodological level. But among the drawbacks, I would like to mention the following. Formulating the purpose of the research, the author writes about the number of European cities which are the part of a research block, but the main attention is paid to the comparison of St. Petersburg and Andalusia, and it defines the content of main two chapters and gave the author opportunity to formulate the novelty of the work. The consideration in the first chapter of different practices of European cities and countries about migrant problem distracted candidate from in-depth comparative analysis of St. Petersburg and Andalusia. Secondly, the main provisions for the defense concerning the definition must be formulated with the element of discursive character. In this very much, formulations are of descriptive character. But my remarks of private character and recommendation character, they don't spoil overall positive impression from the dissertation research, the dissertation of Mara Edinova, the peculiarities of regional and city migration policy, the issue of migrant integration into the host society, conforms with the main requirements stated by the order from the 1st of September 2016, procedure on awarding academic degrees at St. Petersburg University, and the candidate Maria Yedinova deserves the degree of the candidate of political sciences in the specialization 23005, political regional studies, ethnopolitics. Point 11 of the order was not violated by the candidate. Thank you very much. Ivan, the floor is yours. Ivan, we can't hear you. Can you hear me now? Some technical problems. Dear colleagues, allow me to voice my ideas concerning the text of the dissertation. They are reflected in my review. The first is connected with the relevance of the problem. It is an obvious fact. The actuality of the topic is without doubt, because the figuring out the peculiarities of city and regional migration politics in the context of migrant integration into the host society is of scientific interest not only for Western researchers, but for modern Russian scientific practice. There are a lot of subjective prerequisites. I agree with Mariah's report, but I will focus on some moments. Migration policy is one of the most complicated or politicized problems in Russian society. It is characterized by a range of the moments. It is not logical and directions of realizations. Declarative provisions, procedures of preparation of migration documents are bureaucratic, and the process of labor migrations is not from non-visa CIS countries is not regulated. There are some hurdles, such as xenophobia, discrimination of foreign citizens, poor development of adaptation structures, illegal migrations. Very often, foreign citizen is involved into problematic situations. His traditions and norms are not accepted by host society. This question is of special importance. It leads to distrust to the state from the migrants. It is very important. The candidate highlights that in the conditions of crisis connected with pandemic of COVID-19, there is a new condition in the migration integration policy. The concept of migration policy needs further development, new approaches, and the attempt of new and the work of Mariah shows this new approach. The aim is figuring out the peculiarities of city and regional migration policy and the issue of integration to the host society at the city level. Of course, dissertation research devoted to the research of regional city migration policy, the problem of migrants' integration into the host society has scientific actuality and practical interest to such a problem is stipulated by the need to form the system of social and cultural adaptation on foreign citizens into the Russian Federation. And as for provisions, conclusions, the author analyzed many scientific sources on the topic of the research. The main approaches were analyzed and systematized 8 thematic directions in migrational processes were figured out. They were important for the policy of migrants' integration, and it helped study the problem of migrants' integration into the host society. The candidate offered the range of theoretical provisions, which are methodological basis of the dissertation research, and they define their conceptual direction. Interdisciplinary approach was used. Sociology, demography, and economy was studied. The author is based on such an approach is normative and quantitative and qualitative methods were used. The structure of the dissertation reflects the logics of the research. The candidate tries to explain the peculiarities of migrants' integration at the city and the regional level. In domestic practice, there is no experience of long-term realization of migrants' integration policy. And European experience should be borrowed. The methods of defining the extent of integration of migrants, which is used in Western society, the system on indexation of migrants into the host society is based on labor matrix, social welfare, which includes education, healthcare and accommodation, and the access to civil rights. And she offers her own variants of definition of city index of integration. The role of knowledge in the sphere of migration policy and integration policy, and she studies the structures of political dialogues within them. The attempt of the author to analyze institutional design of city migration policy. The angle of the research chosen by the author and the solution of the scientific problems allowed to formulate the final provision for the defense, which can be explained as follows. Policy of integration of migrants at the regional and city migration level are defined by specific characteristics, migration flows, political and economic peculiarities of the region or the city. As for the novelty and reliability of the provisions, the analysis of the dissertation proves the fact that it is one of the first attempts of systematization of theoretical and practical experience at the local decision making level. The channels of interaction in order to institutional design, the level of involvement of NGO and nonprofit organizations into the process, that the systematic character of the research is provided by the logical plan of the dissertation. The analysis of regional and city institution of migrants integrations on the basis of case study of European cities allowed to systematize, typologize, and formulate the index of migrants integrations. These are novel provisions. The theoretical significance is that the analysis is supplements the policy of migrants integration. The dissertation of Maria Edinova is independent scientific research. It is novel, as well as it is holistic. The conclusions are completed and logical. The formulations are clear. The language is scientific, academic. The results are reflected in the correlations of research methodology and content part of the research. And a few remarks. The work is actual and logical. I would like to draw your attention to some discursive moments which possibly will become the subject for further research. It seems to me that the object and subject of the research are formulated too broadly. In this respect, first of all, you need to precise the choice. Spain, Italy, the Netherlands, Great Britain, Germany, and France as an object of the research. Secondly, does it mean uniformity both of migration policy and the trajectory of migrants' integration into the society? Number two, the characteristic of the practices of integration policies is one-sided. Only positive examples are described in the context of multiculturalist approaches and expectations. In order to improve integration policies in Russia, it would be better to study the experience, ways, and methods of the solution of complicated integrational problems. We know that unlike the USA and Western Europe, after the Second World War and migration processes as in the result of which migrants were integrated and they were assimilated by the host society. At the beginning of the 21st century, the situation changed. Many migrants of new wave did not want to accept the values of indigenous people. Number three, the author analyzed the extent of the sources, some topics on these subjects were represented in the Russian Federation. The literature list shows only two Western scholars, Zhukova, Suvorova, Titova, Dmitrieva, Fedorova, doctoral research of Volokha, Ledinova, Tohin, and others explains the peculiarities of migrants into Russia. Without taking into account these works, without taking into account these scientific studies, the relevance of point two of the novelty is doubtful. Citing the concept of migration policy of 2018, the candidate points out that in Russia such approaches were developed and tested, the approaches to social and cultural adaptation of different categories on foreign citizens, including the correspondent programs and in the format of state social partnership with the participation of NGO and non-profit organizations. organizations. Nevertheless, there were analysis. There are not analysis of such approaches, but these remarks are caused by actuality and novelty of the subject of the research. They don't. My remarks don't spoil overall high level of the research, and they are aimed at the improvement of the research material. To conclude, the dissertation is written independently. It is uniform, contains new scientific results and provisions for the defense, and proves the private contribution, personal contribution of the author into the science. The dissertation of Maria Edinova on the topic, the peculiarities of regional and city migration policy, the issue of migrants' integration into the host society, conforms with the order from the 1st of September 2016, 6821/1, procedure on awarding academic degrees in St. Petersburg University, and Maria Edinova deserves the degree of the candidate of political sciences in specialization 23005, political regional studies. Ethnopolitics, points 9 and 11 were not violated by the candidate. Thank you very much for your attention. Ivan, thank you very much. Yuri, the floor is yours. After previous speeches, I have nothing to add. I will be as brief as possible. First of all, Maria worked hard. She analyzed large volume of the material. Her work is very interesting, and the author deserves the degree of the candidate of political sciences. I'm not going to repeat I wrote in my review, which is placed at the website of the university. I would like to stop on some remarks. They are indicated in my review. Only one remark I would like to mention just now. Secondly, remark number two, migration policy and especially practices of migrants' integration should not be considered as a formal process of realization of strategies and models of integration. Legal and doctrinal regulation defines the process, migration process, in every society, in every country, but migration process, it is a process of intercultural interaction. On the one hand, these are migrants, community, and on the other hand, it is host society, host community. And how are migrants percepted by the host society and vice versa? Everything depends on it. And changing character of this interaction corrects the situation and migration policy itself in terms of legal norms. And this part of dissertation paper is poorly studied. To be brief, we are pressed for time. Let me read out our conclusion. On the whole, the dissertation of Maria Edinova on the topic, the peculiarities of regional and city migration policy, the issue of migrant integration into the host society, conforms with the requirements of the order from the 1st of September 2016. Number 6821/1, procedure on awarding academic degrees at St. Petersburg University. The candidate deserves the degree of the candidate of political sciences, specialization 23005, political regional studies, ethnopolitics, point 11, was not violated by the candidate. Thank you very much. Very concise. Artur, the floor is yours. Your opinion. I will try to be as brief as possible. My review is placed on the website of St. Petersburg University. The comparison of two cases are doubtful, but after I read the first and second subchapters, I understood everything. The prerequisites for transformation of national approaches of migration policy and the difference of the types of these strategies, of the implementation of these strategies, and the conclusions became clear. My remarks. Once again, it was very interesting not only to read but also to hear the report of Mariah, and I feel that she knows international terms and with a Western accent involvement and immersion into the Western European system of scientific approach is felt. First of all, technical moment. It seemed to me that the pointing out to the in-depth interview with the representatives of expert society in Spain, the quality of novelty of the work. It's not the novelty. The fact of surveys does not mean the conclusions, and it is a small remark. Page 14 in the dissertation, in the text of dissertation. Despite the widespread existence of in-depth and expert interview of this same method, page 16, in-depth and expert interview differ from each other, both from the point of view of the methods and in terms of the choice of respondents as the sources of information. And I tried to find the number of respondents, experts. You stated the number of Spanish experts, but I could not find Russian experts. One more remark about the different types of migrants communities don't have real social and political in due to fragment character. Page 19 of the dissertation, we know that ethnical migrant communities, they organize with the aim to lobbying their interests, and very often they are called according their national, ethnical and cultural feature, and due to this fact we can understand which migrant society lobbies their interests through NGO. Sometimes they do it with the help of non-formal ways. That's why to speak about the fact that this activity is ineffective is wrong. And the conclusions about the differences in character of migration flows, that they stipulate the prevalence of specific dominance of migrant integration policy, including instrumental, social, economic, cultural, and legal, page 19, is trivial. Migration policy as a legal or economic component, on the one hand, it reacts the migrant flows. On the other hand, it takes into account the necessity of specific resources, the content of such migration flows, their peculiarities, resourceful base, and so on. It is too trivial. Unfortunately, I could not find the program of the territory, the regions of the Russian Federation, and I could not find the program countrymen. The program is very interesting, the context of the analysis of dissertation research. Unfortunately, I could not find any information about countrymen program. And finally, to what extent of migration politics, policy of St. Petersburg is typical? And how can it be applied as an effective model? But this moment don't spoil the significance of the work. My conclusion is the following: the dissertation of Maria Edinova on the topic the peculiarities of regional and city migration policy, the issue of migrants' integration into the host society conforms with main requirements stated by the order from the 1st of September 2016, procedure on awarding academic degrees at St. Petersburg University, and Maria deserves the degree of the candidate of political sciences in specialization 23005, political regional studies, ethnopolitics. Point 11 of the order was not violated. Thank you for your attention. Thank you very much. And please allow me to say a few words about the dissertation of distinguished Maria Sergeevna. I remember this candidate from the first course of the university. She was very responsible. Then she became postgraduate student, and she liked scientific activity very much. And the product we have got today, it is a decent result of the efforts of Maria and her scientific supervisor, Valerie. I'm not going to read out the whole review. I would like to focus on some things of technical character. It seems to me that they are very important. Here we speak about the combination of methodological and methodical approach to the problem. The use of classical general scientific analytical methods combined with the variants of neo-institutionalism. And if we speak about methods, she uses the combinations of quantitative and qualitative methods, the use of index system materials of expert interview in this series of expert interview conducted by the author. It is very important point. Allow me to focus on that. At the end of June, there will be the defense of candidate dissertation. The candidate discusses the questions connected with qualitative methods of political science, particularly in Russia. One of the provisions is connected with the fact that we don't have a tradition of combination of qualitative and quantitative methods. And the dissertation, Maria's dissertation, shows that our young scholars can solve these problems. And what is new in this text, in this scientific product in comparison to other works? It's not a secret that very often, candidate dissertations retell other ideas with a sort of rewriting. Today, the situation is different. What is new in this dissertation, and so the list is quite long. Mariah offers authors' definition of integration, migrants' integration policy. Secondly, the author offers the typology of the types of integration migrants policy at city and regional level, and it is demonstrated with the help of two cases. They were mentioned today. Mariah solved the problem with actual insider information, and she conducted the series of expert interviews. It is impossible to take any person, and the work proves that political policy of migrants' integration into the autonomous societies with the elements of multi-level management and financial interaction between different political and social actors gives brilliant results. It is important political and practical conclusion. Also, candidate uses the logical scheme of analysis of initial parameters of migrational adaptation. It includes such indicators as the country of origin, aim, type, and reason for migrations, and the development of formal bodies with ethnical migration communities. The advantage of the work is the fact that the author showed how at the local level can political and economic situation in this specific region or city can be transformed, how apart from that, Mariah analyzed in detail the peculiarities of migration's integration policy at city and regional level, the analysis of the freedom of local and regional authorities in terms of use their rights concerning migrants, their professional preparation, the important direction of the development of this topic is the discussion of trilateral interaction of authorities of regional or local business and regional and local NGO and non-profit organizations with the aim of migrants' integration. Without doubt, it is the deviation from the main topic of the research, but for us who live in political science, it is a very important moment. The question of readiness of authorities to cooperate with expert society in this part, the conclusions of Mariah are too critical, but they correspond to the reality, and they are different from the picture which is offered by analysts. Mariah offered authors complex index of integration of migrants at city level as an instrument of the analysis. She included into it such variables as the labor market, social welfare, and the access of migrants to civil rights, and finally, the advantage of the work is the scheme of network analysis in the broad sense from local communities to international organizations which help migrants' adaptation into the host society. These components maybe are of private character, but in fact, they demonstrate visible efforts and results of Mariah's work on the topic of dissertation research. I want to say that I don't often like the dissertation texts, but this text is different. There are some technical drawbacks. When you describe formal and non-formal practices, you analyze cases reflecting the strategy of the research. It is correct that the but the project would be of higher heuristic value if you collected the information with other existing methods and if you explained the request for use them in this or that those situations. Then process character in the formulation of some tasks for the of the research. And the same situation is with the formulation of the results which we achieved. Results 3 and 4 are very strange. Number 3 to make the results of the research more objective, you adapt to some forms of activity of authorities. It is called inclusive supervision. In the text of the dissertation, you mention the circumstance that for several years you have been taking part in the meeting of the section of governmental bodies on migration policy within the frames of Labour Forum. Why is this fact? How does this fact help you conduct a depth analysis of the topic? Number 4, it is not a remark. It is advice. Any scientific knowledge is effective when it is it does not only describe the situation, but when it allows to give predictive analysis. You know, the topic of integration of migrants is a very difficult topic, but some predictive analysis concerning adaptation should be given. I liked the study. It is a completed qualitative scientific work. In my opinion, the dissertation of Edinova on the topic the peculiarities of regional and city migration policy, the issue of migrants' integration into the host society conforms with the main requirements stated by the order from the 1st of September 2016, number 6821/1, procedure on awarding academic degrees at St. Petersburg State University, and our candidate, Maria Edinova, deserves the degree of the candidate of political sciences, specialization 23005, political regional studies, ethnopolitics, point 9 and 11, were not violated by our candidate. Dear colleagues, thank you for your attention. I hope we will hear the answers of Maria. First of all, I would like to express my gratitude to the chairperson and board members for your feedback and the interest to my dissertation research. Then, allow me to answer all the questions in turn. I would like to express my gratitude to Professor Vasileva. Turning to the cases in the first chapter helped to see the whole spectrum of integration practices, analyze urban networks, descend in theoretical terms from the national level, and traditional consideration of the politics of multiculturalism to the local and trace the transformation of national migration strategies. All this allowed in subsequent chapters to look at the policy of integration in migrants in St. Petersburg and Andalusia against a comparative background. As for the second remark of Professor Natalia Vasilieva, I generally agree with it. Thank you very much. I'm grateful to the Professor Vladimir Ivan Radikov. Let me answer your questions. Cases from Italy, the Netherlands, Great Britain, Germany, France illustrates that such practices can be universal. They should be adapted to the specifics and peculiarities of migration flows. Then pages 105-106, the attitude to the Spanish population towards migrants living in enclaves is analyzed, both in large cities of Spain, Barcelona and Madrid, and in small towns, Granada, Malaga. The host community is concerned about the closed enclave residence of migrants from China. Small grocery stores and stalls owned by migrants are called chinas, which is translated from Spanish is Chinese. As for the third remark, I agree with it. I am familiar with the most of the listed work, but these doctoral and candidate studies are not used in the text. That is, there are no direct references to these works. Nevertheless, monographs and articles of the authors are used. Paragraphs 134, 128, 130, 132, list of sources used, page 145-149. Then the volume of work, unfortunately, does not allow to analyze all regions of Russia. The main objects of research are St. Petersburg and Andalusia. Therefore, are the experience of the policy of integrated migrants remained outside the scope of work, but will certainly become the object of further research. The following programs were analyzed in the work. Items 2, 3, 4, 9 of the list of sources used. It should be noted that, unfortunately, the provisions of the concept of migration policy and practice are not always the same. The declared approaches are not always reflected in practice. Ivan Vladimirovich, thank you very much for your feedback. I would like to express my gratitude to Professor Yuri Shabai for the interest to my work. Let me consider all your remarks and proposals. Number one, in the scientific literature, there is another point of view. The combination of migration policy and ethnopolitics leads to the fact that instead of real people, the economic and social problems, ethnic groups become the object of management, which leads to non-targeted migration policy. Thus, Vladimir Malakhov notes that conceptualizing what is happening in the society as a manifestation, exacerbation, harmonization, and so on of inter-ethnic relations, we stop seeing real people. Instead of real interest groups and real organizations, ethnic groups are the agents of social interaction. In another work, the researcher defines this approach as methodological ethnocentrism, that is, a view of society as a conglomerate of ethnic groups, in which ethnic completely covers the social, economic, and political. I agree with the second remark. The survey of migrants would enrich the work. However, I took part in a survey carried out by the Department and of Ethnopolitology of the Faculty of Political Science, St. Petersburg University. I considered it impossible to use the acquired collective knowledge in my work. In 2020, there was an agreement with the International Association for Legal Assistance to Labor Migrants to conduct a survey of migrants. Unfortunately, the plans were not implemented due to the pandemic. The subjectivity of the research primarily includes institutional design, so the work focuses more on formal and informal institutions implementing the policy of integrating migrants. Number three, there is no doubt that opposition organizations in relations to the ruling institutions of the country of origins have an influence on migration processes in the recipient country, host country. One of the number four, it should be noted that many religious organizations are formally present in all councils and commissions on inter-ethnic and migration issues under the governor of St. Petersburg. However, it is difficult to assess how great the informal influence of this organization is. Well, in Europe, you can find a large number of studies in this focus. In the Russian Federation, such sources, unfortunately, did not come across to me is thank you very much for your feedback and the attention to the dissertation research. I would like to express my gratitude to Artur Atanisyan. Let me answer your questions in turn. The opinions of representatives of the scientific community and municipal government bodies in Spain are not available to the majority of the members of the Russian scientific community. It seems to me that these interviews are of practical importance. Of course, my primary focus is on the interpretation of the interview data. As for the second remark of Professor Atanisyan, I agree with it. The work uses the term of in-depth interviews to reflect non-standardized, partially structured interviews with a flexible coding system, where the emphasis was more on the reasoning and forecast of experts, their personal assessments, than on the collection of actual expert data. Such an emphasis of in-depth interviews is based on the approaches of grounded theory of theories, Chalmers, expressed in a number of publications, including the publishing house Sage. Number three, on page 112 of the thesis, the total number of interviews conducted is on page 14, of which is 14, of which 12 were for the analysis of the St. Petersburg case. Number four, within the framework of one work, is not possible to evaluate all organizations, but based on the analysis carried out on some nonprofit organizations act, inter alia, on the basis of the interests of their members. The phenomenon of ethnic entrepreneurship, conflict of interests, etc., are of some importance, but it should be emphasized that this is certainly not the case for all non-profit organizations. Within the framework of network analysis, the influence was assessed according to the following parameters of the actors: centrality within the network, the number of connections, density being the clothes of the network. Then, this provision for researchers is possible and trivial, but it does not seem obvious at the level of representatives of government institutions. Number six, the compatriots program. Unfortunately, when beyond the focus of the dissertation research, since it seems that the interaction of former compatriots is easier due to the fact that they are carriers of Russian culture and language. Respectively, the issues of their integration are not acute as the problem of integration for the Russian-speaking labor migrants. Then, the study did not find a universal model of integration policy. The local tone once again reflected the existing differences in the implementation of the policy of integration of migrants within one state due to the different characteristics of the migration situation in specific cases. The adoption of one model equally effective for different migration flows, characteristics of institutions of a particular city or region is not possible. It is worth highlighting the common features of the migration policy of Moscow and St. Petersburg, since these cities are the largest megacities and receive large flows of migrants. Migration policy in other regions and cities of Russia differs significantly due to smaller flows of migrants, excellent resources, opportunities, etc. Thank you very much for the interest to my work. I would like to thank Professor Pafova, Olga, for her feedback, for her interest to the dissertation research, and allow me to answer your questions in turn. Number one, a bottom-up research strategy is applied to reflect the multifactorial impact on the migration situation and accordingly on the integration policy. The dynamics and heterogeneity of migration flows leads to the absence of universally successful practices for integrating migrants and the existence of only a certain range of practices without a single ideal model that could be tried to be implemented regardless of the context. The study of the European practice of integrating migrants showed that there is no ideal model here either, since all European Union states that use various models of integration policy have faced serious problems. So there is not much to compare the studied cases with. It is possible to borrow experience, but rather it is about the experience of overcoming crisis situations. I agree with the chairman of the Dissertation Council. In terms of the second remark, I chose an unsuccessful wording. Of course, I meant the results of obtained and not the process of achieving them. During the work within the framework of the forum, access was obtained to potential experts, respondents. I took an active part in the work of sections, meetings on, and on this basis and understanding of the institutional design of the authorities in the field of migration policy and the policy of integration of migrants was formed. Moving to forecasting the migration situation in St. Petersburg for the next period after the end of the pandemic, most of all, there will be an increase in migration flows from the post-Soviet states. It is worth emphasizing that during the pandemic, flows did not decrease so dramatically. At the moment, it is obvious that the labor market is indeed of labor migrants. Wages of workers over the past years have grown by how many percent, which will certainly play a role in increasing migration flows. There is a tendency towards the digitalization of the migration sphere. Today in Petersburg and Leningrad region, applications are being created for finding work for migrants, for processing documents, passing exams, labor field of migrants. Of principal significance is interaction with employers in terms of employment of migrants. Thank you very much for the interest, for the attention to my research. Distinguished colleagues, are you satisfied with Mariah's answers? Are there any other questions? No questions. Thank you very much. The meeting is open. There are people in the hall who are non-board members. Dear non-board members, are there any volunteers who wants to have the floor? No volunteers. I have a question to our curator. Are there any questions concerning dissertations? No questions. Now I would like to give the floor to the scientific supervisor, Valery Achkasov. Judging from Mariah's speech and answers to questions and remarks, it is obvious that we work with completed and mature researcher who is ready for in-depth study of scientific problems and practical problems, as well as the problems connected with migration. We have been working with Mariah for many years. I have known her very well. I know her very well. She's hardworking. She can't refuse. She's able to solve many problems. And the proof is her dissertation research. She is an initiative person. She had internship in two Spanish university, and she used this opportunity in a proper way. She conducted researches there. She got acquainted with Andalusian migration policy. She understood how the policy of migrants integration realized there in St. Petersburg. She used the opportunity. She worked in organization committee of all international forum labor forums in St. Petersburg, and she used this opportunity to receive the access to experts community and to receive the opportunity to conduct interviews. And she took part in all sessions and panel discussions on labor forums. One program was discussed the problem of migration policy, as well as the problem of migrants' integration. Unfortunately, negative moments were discussed there. I visited Labour Forum last year, this session, which discussed the practice of slavery of labour migrants. We discussed the problems of legal provision of migration policy. On the one hand, there are nearly 170 legal acts, federal acts, concerning migrants. But on the other hand, recently in our House of Nationalities, there was a panel discussion. The representatives of non-profit organizations from 21 regions came, and unanimously they discussed the following. One of the barriers for working with barriers in terms of integration is there is no definition of integration of migrants in Russian legislation. When there was a meeting of experts council in the Russian Academy of Science under the guidance of academician Yuri Kishkov, we were invited to solve the problem of the law on a Russian nation. We discussed another question, the bill which tried to define migrants' integration and migrants' adaptation. These two definitions were the same in this bill, and it was one of the main reasons for rejecting at the level of expert council and preliminary discussion at State Duma. And concerning non-profit organizations, it's a strong barrier in terms of including active. That's why I support Mariah's statement that the context of the strategy of migrants policy is a great difference. And for our state officials, the Spanish experience is very actual. It was deeply studied by Mariah. There is a lot of literature devoted to migration policy in key countries of European Union, Germany, France, Scandinavian countries, Great Britain. But there are only separate articles in Russian concerning Spanish migration policy. But at the national level, Spanish case has not been was not studied before. Her study is a great contribution into the study of migration policy. On the whole, I would like to express my gratitude to the board members for positive feedback concerning Mariah's study. Thank you very much. And I think that I can support the statements of board members that Mariah deserves the degree of the candidate of political sciences, specialization 23005, political regional studies, ethnopolitics. Thank you for your attention. Valery, thank you very much. According to the procedure of our meeting, are there any volunteers among board members or among those who are present today? Would you like to express your ideas? No one wants. The discussion and accepting of questions are finished. Do Dear colleagues, do you have any remarks or questions concerning the procedure of the meeting, as well as connected with the remote interactive mode? And now voting. It is 4:31 p.m. Moscow time. 4:31 p.m. Moscow time. And before we start voting, I would like to ask a question. Is there a necessity to announce a break to discuss the defense results with the broadcast sound muting? Do you think we need such a break to discuss the results of the defense? We continue the meeting, and I raise the question of awarding Maria Yedinova the degree of candidate of political sciences in the scientific specialization 23005, political regional studies ethnopolitics, on an open roll call. I remind you that the decision of the Dissertation Council on the issue of awarding the academic degree is considered positive if more than half, but at least three members of the Dissertation Council who participated in the meeting voted for it, in accordance with clause 23 of the procedure. Board member Natalia Vasilieva, your opinion. I'm for the degree. Ivan Radikov, your opinion. Everything is prepared at high professional level, this study. I'm for the degree of candidates political sciences specialization 23005. Yuri Shabaev, your opinion? I'm for. Board member Atur Atanisyan, your opinion? I'm for the degree. And me, chairperson of this dissertation council, Olga Popova, I join the opinion, I support the opinion of my colleagues, and I am for the degree. Thus, distinguished colleagues and guests, I announce that out of four board members participating in the voting, five voted for, no one voted against, and there is no one who abstained from vote. The decision on awarding Maria Yedinova an academic degree of the candidate of political sciences specialization 23005, political regional studies ethnopolitics, is accepted. We congratulate you on this wonderful event, and I think that it is a great event for the political science. Thank you very much. I would like to express my gratitude for the attention and interest to my dissertation. Dear chairperson, dear board members, I would like to thank my scientific supervisor, Valery Achkasov, for his support and advice. For advice and recommendations, members of the Department of Ethnopolitology, St. Petersburg University. On the whole, I am grateful to St. Petersburg University for the opportunity to conduct scientific research. Thank you very much. Dear colleagues, thank you very much. We have finished. I declare the meeting closed. I thank everyone for participation. Please switch off the live broadcast of the meeting. And then we will congratulate you.